Hey everyone, Clueless Dad here. I have a new apartment, and what I'm going to show you in this video today is how to loft a IKEA TARVA bed to take advantage of that giant windowsill. So I live in Hong Kong, and in Hong Kong space is a premium. And also for some strange reason, I think for like zoning or taxes or something, almost all rooms in new buildings come with gigantic windowsills. So that windowsill is like 28 inches deep. And if you don't use it right, that space goes to waste. So if I wanted to put a bed here and just put it on the floor, like say a double bed, it would literally come out to here, and then all that space on the windowsill would go to waste because it's behind the headboard, you can't really access it. So what a lot of people end up doing in cases like this is they'll loft their bed up. So what most people do is they actually pay a guy that custom makes some furniture that fits their apartment, and then they'll have some storage underneath. I don't have the time or the money to do that, and because I'm a cheapskate, I decided to hack some IKEA furniture to do it for us. So today we're gonna take a TARVA bed, which normally looks like this, and we're gonna do what I dub the TARVA inversion. So basically we're gonna take the headboard and turn it into legs that will lift the bed up above the floor, and we'll actually have some storage space underneath. So that's pretty cool. It's not gonna be super attractive, but it's totally practical, and literally this bed only costs about 900 something Hong Kong. So for that price, you get the lofted bed, you get to use all that space, and on top of that, relatively simple. So in this video, I'll show you a few simple steps to accomplish this goal, and hopefully most of you guys watching this can do it yourself as well. All it takes is basically the normal tools to assemble an IKEA bed, plus you need a good saw and a drill. So I've just opened up the TARVA box. As you can see, it's really just a bunch of untreated pine planks with some holes pre-drilled. So even cheaper than the normal IKEA stuff. This one doesn't even have any finish on it, no paint, no nothing. So I'm gonna wanna lacquer this up, but I'll do that another time. For the sake of today's video, I'll skip that. So except for the end pieces, this is basically the full length of the bed. So as you can see, if I were to put it on the floor, it would reach out somewhere like this long. But if I am able to put it on the windowsill, it's much further over, which means I get to use a lot more of my floor space. And I can basically keep all kinds of stuff under here. So the trick with this hack is to focus on the legs. So these are the legs of the bed. As you can see, this is the short one. This normally goes by your feet. And this is the one at the head of the bed. And as you can see here, this is where the headboard fits in. So for this hack, we're actually gonna put this one at the head of the bed up here on the shelf. And we're gonna take this one and install it upside down so that the what was the head of the bed is now kind of a stand. So the trick is you've gotta adapt it to fit with your shelf height. These are the pins that you put in, that you put bolts through to screw the thing together. So I just put them in temporarily so that we can actually find out where they would line up, these two legs line up together. And basically, if this is flat on the floor, you want this leg to get cut in order to match up with the height of your shelf. So if the world was perfect, you know, this thing would line up perfectly. It just depends on how high your shelf is. But in Hong Kong, they seem to all be about 20 inches or 21 inches or so. So in this case, if I have this one on the floor, you can see I have whatever, 4 inches too long here. And then you face another issue, which is if you put this thing in upside down, so now the headboard is the foot, and what was the foot is now sticking up off the top. And so as you see, like there's gonna be the cross beam, plank, whatever, the thing that the bed sits on, going across here, and this is gonna be sticking up. And now this is gonna be the foot of your bed, which means you're gonna have these little sticks sticking up, which might be good for, I don't know, hanging clothes off of, hanging your belts, etc. But I think more likely you're probably gonna smash your toe on there when you're getting out of bed, or you know, tripping on it. Who knows what's gonna happen. So we're also gonna cut this off. So it'll get cut off at the same level as this one, and you wanna also have it be straight. So now the next question then comes in, how do I cut these things straight? So let's say I put this up here, this is straight, I try to get this level, and then I can mark on this beam, on this leg, where to cut, and so now I gotta cut it. So in my case, I went over to my friend's house last night, and through the magic of movies, already cut it. So I actually did one as an example last night with my friend, and so thank you to Sean for your awesome chop saw which is able to cut nice and straight. And also he did a little work with the sander to get a nice rounded edge on the cutoff part. So you can almost, you can't tell that much the difference between the part that he cut, so this was the long leg here, and what was originally on the one straight from IKEA, which has a little nice chamfered edge on it. Okay, so let's double check how our measurements came out. Actually, it's not quite perfect. If I keep this one flat on the shelf here, there is actually a little bit of space here on the bottom. As you can see, it wiggles a little bit. But then again, if I push it down, there's only a little bit of gap coming up here. So it's maybe like a 32nd of an inch too long on this one. But that's okay, because actually this bed has feet. So these are little feet that nail in here. So if I nail in a foot on here and I nail in a foot on here, it'll end up being, you know, pretty close. And also keep in mind that these things are, what, like 6 feet something apart? So a 32nd of an inch across that is like basically the same thing as level. So whether you use the feet or not actually probably doesn't matter. So before we start assembling everything, there's one more cut that we need to make in the wood. So normally this is the head of the bed, and this is the headboard centerpiece. And this piece, which is this metal bracket, holds the kind of center spine of the bed in place and screws in like this, normally where this is the head of the bed at the top. And so the problem is we want to install it upside down, which would be something like this. So the problem is this piece of wood interferes. So you could actually kind of put some spacers on there and get some longer screws and have it just go in like that. But unfortunately that'll mean it'll rattle and be unstable. So what we're going to do is we're actually just going to chop this piece of wood off. And so instead of being a nice kind of T-joint, it'll actually only be a lap joint. But for the sake of this, I think that's actually fine. And don't worry, because we're also going to be strengthening the ends. Got everything unpacked, got my Allen wrench ready. Let's do time-lapse assembly. 3, 2, 1. Okay, that took a while, but you can now finally see it taking shape. So with our cut legs on the ledge and our former headboard as this kind of lofting legs. So it looks pretty good, right? There's a lot of space underneath and whatnot. I still need to go through and put the side rails and all the slats and whatnot on there. But you're getting at least an initial idea of how it will look. And one other thing I wanted to add that you definitely need to consider. So this leg is originally the headboard. So it's designed to, you know, people push on the headboard, people lean against it, but it's not the same thing as, you know, all the weight being put through it. So in this case, what I decided to do was get an L bracket. So this is just a metal bracket that can screw in into that joint there, that corner, so that in case there are some large bending moments or, you know, the heavy force on here, this thing can help spread the load around and basically resist this thing being rupturing here, because that's where the point of highest stress will be. And if it's not there, it'll actually be around these two screws, because that's basically the only thing connecting this one and this one. So there's a chance on this soft pine that it might fail. So this thing should help us out with that. And because this is such soft wood, I could probably just drive these screws in. These are like number 8 screws. Just drive it straight into the wood without drilling a hole, but being the perfectionist, actually not really perfectionist, but being the sound engineer I am going to actually use a small drill to drill a couple holes just to make sure that it's nice and well done. So here we are. I've got my brackets. They're about 3/4 inch wide by 6 inches by 6 inches, And this is only 7/8, so it's a little bit narrow, but not super critical that you get it exactly centered or anything. So just don't go off the edge and you should be fine. So here we are with the brackets installed, super easy. Even I didn't get it perfectly straight, that's fine. It was super easy because the wood is so soft. Now I feel safe that I can jump in and out of bed without fear of breaking this thing. Voila. Okay, so last up, we gotta put the slats on, which means we need to put these little side L rails on. And of course, keep in mind that we're putting this thing in upside down, so it'll be the opposite of what it looks like in the picture. So I gotta put 16 of these annoying screws in. So let's do time lapse, 3, 2, 1. Okay, yeah, I totally cheated. I used the screw gun because I didn't want to have to twist so much, but I definitely recommend you be very careful with that because you could totally strip the heads of the screws and you might crack the wood. So again, be careful, but it is a pain in the butt to screw those in all by hand. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, last step. Okay, just need a mattress and we're done. Okay, so here we are, finally done. As you can see, the mattress is actually the most fun part. This is a Malvik foam mattress that we got, and it actually says in here, don't sleep on it for 72 hours, because you can see it's still inflating. So they basically like vacuum pack it, then roll it up, and even before I cut the plastic, it was already starting to swell. It was actually pretty cool. And look at all that space we've got down here. Store all kinds of stuff down here. And I'm actually cheating because this is not even fully up against the windowsill. So you can see we've got a decent amount of space here. If the bed was like put like normal, it would actually be out maybe to the plugs. But in this case, we're going to slide it over all the way to the windowsill. Actually, slides pretty easy. So easy to adjust as you need it. If you need more floor space, slide it in. So now you can see not quite as much space underneath. We've got all this space, so literally like this much extra space that we've saved. So that's the difference between having cabinets that hit the end of the bed when you open them or having space to actually stand there and get dressed without climbing all over everything. So anyway, you can actually see a stain of whoever previous guy's cabinets there left a stain on the floor. So anyway, that's how it looks. Pretty decent, I'd say. And again, considering the price of this thing, it's only like about 120 US. Especially for a place like Hong Kong, way easier than getting something custom built, especially if you're in a hurry, you don't have a lot of money. And so again, let's just take a quick look. You can see the amount of effort required, actually not too bad. Basically, just screwing these guys in, trimming that center piece at the end there, you can't even tell I cut it, and of course flipping this thing upside down, and it was cut here. But basically looks good as new. You can't even tell that was cut. And then trimmed these legs, and you can basically tell those are trimmed because they're so stubby. But only thing I would say on the downside is not really much you can do with that space. I guess you could put, you know, books or magazines or something, something flat, put some important papers. But the only other kind of positive or negative thing is that the bed is pretty high up. So my mother-in-law, who is quite petite, just looked at it and she's like, wow, that bed is so high. But hey, you can still climb up here. I'm sure my kid is going to start climbing up these things like a ladder to jump on the bed. Right now, he definitely can't climb up here, which is actually probably a good thing. But he will be able to climb up there and then climb up there. So one way or another, he's going to get in if not right away, then pretty soon. So I guess falling out of bed would be a little bit more serious, but he's getting old enough where he doesn't even do that anymore. Okay, so that's it for the inverted Tarva. If you guys live in Hong Kong and you've tried this, or if you've done something similar with a different IKEA bed, do let us know. If you have any other good ideas for IKEA hacks you want me to try, leave them in the comment section below. Give us a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and share this video as much as possible. I would love to have some Hong Kong-based home design blogs share this, because I think this is totally useful for anyone. I wish I knew about it many years ago when I first started renting apartments in Hong Kong. It would have saved me a bundle of floor space. Okay, so that's it for today. See you guys next time from the Clueless Dad. Bye.